Those who want to know exactly what changes the governor wants to make in the Constitution may have been disappointed in his news conference this morning. Good evening, I'm Cynthia Arsenault. Landry says changes to the Constitution are needed to help the legislature make Louisiana more competitive. However, he doesn't say what specific changes he wants to see. Teresa Schmidt reports.
Landry defended the constitutional convention he proposes, saying it's needed to help Louisiana move forward.
This is about giving the legislature the tools to address the problems that we know are coming.
And Landry said in the fiscal session next year, if there's a budget shortfall, lawmakers wouldn't be limited to cutting health care and education.
We go to start working and figuring out how we can minimize the cuts to education and to healthcare and to try to minimize the bloodbath in this building that goes on every time that happens.
He briefly addressed items some people consider sacrosanct.
Homestead exemption can stay in the Constitution. I met with the sheriffs that day. Supplemental pay can stay in the Constitution. But all of the things that are underneath those that don't allow the legislature to look at them should be moved into a particular statute.
He says getting it on the ballot this November is crucial because since it's a presidential election, more people will have a chance to vote. Plus, he says it will pave the way for tax reform.
Because again, we got a fiscal session. If we're going to address taxes, we have to address it next year. Or we have to call the legislature into a special session to do so.
Dustin Granger of Lake Charles is an advocate for a fair convention and is concerned protections will be removed from the Constitution.
There's a lot of money that is protected for our citizens, health, education, K-12 education, our homestead exemption that we all value across the state, but also sales tax exemptions for groceries, utilities, and prescriptions, which just those three for sales tax exemptions amounts to about $1 billion.
Granger predicts Landry is paving the way to create tax breaks for special interest groups and the wealthy. Next year during the fiscal session. Teresa Schmidt, 7 News.
The bill to call a constitutional convention awaits consideration by the full House. If approved, the convention will take place in May. The search for a new McNeese president is over. Late this afternoon, the University of Louisiana Board of Supervisors picked Dr. Wade Roos. He's currently the executive vice president at McNeese. He will replace the retiring Daryl